from there. Not a bad morning so far. It's not that humid like last week. It is a bit better. So I'm just having my breakfast, making myself coffee. Getting ready to go in. It's 6 o'clock, so 6:30. I'll have to go in to unload, and then will be a bit of back and forth, unfortunately. Yeah, going to the mines, salt mine, then in the town to the agent, then back here to unload what I'm picking up from agent for these guys, and then going to in the road station. And then come back, put everything together, and yeah, start driving towards there. So I can get there by Friday afternoon and pick up where I want to try this and go up the highway. Okay. I'm done with these guys for the moment. Now need to break down this one before hooking up on a tow liner. Okay, so always looking for a easy and efficient way. So just separated the fridge from the dry pan. So now I can hook on a tow liner. When I'm coming back with a tow liner, reverse it straight into the dry pan, and that two trailers go to Perth with me, then hook up on a fridge, go to Mindero, and when I'm coming back, hook up the dolly and push everything in the front of the two which are connected, and we are on our way. When I get to Carnarvon, just drop the last two, park the one with the dolly behind and hook up on the other two and go to Perth. Easy. Easy peasy. Yep, easy and efficient at the same time. Yep, it's hooked up. Okay, coming back from Onslow. Everything else done, only me and the roll left. Don't have to go to the agent in town because they delivered. They delivered that yesterday themselves. So one less job for me. No, they done quite a bit of progress here. The bridge here. So now you can hook this one straight into the dry pan and have a double. And I'm coming from in the row with the fridge, hook the dolly behind and both of them into this double and Bob's your, and Bob's your uncle on the way to Nanatara. Quickly, I have to check the heights. All adjusted now, just to hook in. That's it. Now
copy your window.
Unhook all this and get the fridge.
To the right, just come.
Okay. Time to hit the road and go to Mindoro. back on the lovely dirt road. But they got it wrong again. When it's a bit more difficult because you have to be extra careful being on unknown territory, but once you've been once, you know exactly what to expect. Time which may be a bit curly, it's if it's wet, if it's raining, because I don't know what to expect, but yeah, till then on a dry, no more dramas. there. Okay, now time to go and chase these people. Okay, let's hope I'm not gonna get stuck. Good. Really tired, eh? Wow. And I have to leave room for the telehandler to get in as well. Okay. Whew. That was bit of a exercise. Guys, they only have a small cool room. I'm struggling big time to put all that stuff in. To get the other three trailers. Finally back on the sealed road. Now quickly into Wheatstone and get together two trailers. Okay. Now get the dolly behind and then hook up everything together. Okay, so time to go, right? Thank you.
your left and what the fuck, heading back my trophy.
Yeah, come in.
Outside, eh? Not bad. supposed to be only 37. So with this extra drop, it is putting me about a good 2.5 hours behind. Usually one o'clock, I was leaving the Natara. Now I won't be there until 3 o'clock. So by the time I have a shower and all that, will be 3:30. So yes, 2.5 hours behind. Tomorrow I get to depot, change trailers, and get to Auburn before my hours finish. I'm more than happy. I can do all the booking and everything on Saturday morning. Alright, time to have a shower.
Road train pulling out another tower, heading southbound.
That was nice. After a good shower, I feel like a baby. Southbound out of Nanatara. Again to 90, see how it goes, may even better because it's already 45 outside, it's 4 o'clock in afternoon, so 3 hours later than usual, leaving Nanatara. Degrees. As soon as there's no wind, it's hot. When the wind pick up and it's having a bit of a breeze, it's not that hot, but it's dusty, you can't see anything. Either way you go, still no good. right between Nanatara and Minilia. Slowly dropping, but still holding up over 40. If I'll make it to Overlander tonight. It's already 5 o'clock and I'm still good 2 hours, 2.5 hours from Carnarvon. By the time I'll refuel in Carnarvon, drop this trailer, yeah, I may have a chance to make it to Overlander, but yeah. No way to make it further than that. To Minilia, that's our Nakora. We are 2.5 hours to a good 2.5 hours to Carnarvon. If not more. So far it's okay, but if I'll get some nasty winds on the other side of Minilia, I'm stopped. reality, as soon as you hook up the third trailer, fuel economy, it's up the roof. It doesn't matter if it's inland or coastal, same. Usually, Carnarvon to Dea and back to Carnarvon, 550, 600 liters at the most, with two trailers. Now with three, I reckon it's about 800 liters, if not more. Found out soon. Okay. All right. So I wasn't far of how much fuel. 840 liters. About 300 liters at least more than I usually use. Just because an extra trailer. Okay, now to train area to drop a trailer and to make my way towards Perth. Thank you. this light before. Rotrenera is one of that with no lights.
We're going through this Caltex here. It's a bit easy to get in and out. Ciao.
Brilliant when you see nothing.
I can go around the back there, can I? Yeah, look far right outside of them.
Okay, it looks okay. All right, put a trailer and on the way.
the pills and gun, Rob, I get to go.
Thanks, mate. To go all the way to the end, so I'm gonna sneak in the front of this guy. Like this, I'm not gonna get blocked in. Plus, I'm getting protected a bit by the bush. When someone is coming from south, wanna have his high beams right into my windscreen. Alright, so yeah, that's it. That's it for tonight. You guys take care, be safe out there, and we'll see you in the morning. Till then, good night. Good morning, guys, and welcome back. Hello. Leaving Overlanda on the way to Perth. Should be, if everything goes all right, should be in Perth in about 8.5-9 hours at the most. So being 8 a.m. Talking about 5 p.m. 5:30. Yeah, between 4:30 and 5:30. I may stop in a way in to fill up, so I don't have to do it when I'm leaving. Excuse me. Well, saying that, it's only 8 a.m. and it's already in the high 30s. So, I need to slow down a bit if we don't get out of this heat zone before it's reaching 40 and over. My coffee and having my breakfast, I saw a group of crows wandering around my truck, and knowing how hot it's outside, I cut a plastic bottle in half, filled her up with water and put it next to the truck. They didn't even run away too far when I stepped out, and as soon as I left the water there on the ground, didn't even get inside of the cabin, and they already they are drinking. Poor things. They are suffering too on this heat. I know better, it's isolation, but still, them being shiny black, that's attracting heat even more. How the trip goes from this point. Okay, so with this extra delivery point on my run, it's actually pushing me a good 3 hours behind the schedule that I was doing now, till now, which on a good day is not bad. I can live with it. But if I have a really late start from there, then that would bring me in a bit of a trouble. Cattle station that I'm doing. I was wondering, because when you hear about cattle stations, yeah, it's a guy that owns 2,000 hectares of land and cattle and that, nothing too fancy. And then I went on this one, and then I saw, whoa, sealed airstrip, which can accommodate small jets, all the facilities there and everything. Wow, this is big, this is fancy, what's going on? Well, later on we found out who the owner is. So, once you know who the owner is, you don't expect anything less than that. Because actually that cattle station is owned by Twiggy. For who doesn't know who Twiggy is, it's Andrew Forrest. Who's Andrew Forrest? Well, the guy which owns a third of FMG. So it's one of the Australian billionaires. Now, knowing who the owner is, you won't expect anything less than what is there. No wonder why this cattle station is so fancy. Yeah, so this is the story with Mindero station. Anything interesting in Northampton? really. Down. Noticed in this town, except 440, it's not much where you can stop with a truck and buy anything if you wanna get water or food or something. Forget about it. Speed limits in this town. They never sit in a 100 zone or on a 60 zone. They always sit in a 90 and 70 zone with their Jupiter. Oh, finally, we're getting into Dongra. 12 o'clock. Perfect for lunch. Perfect for lunch. Time for lunch. See you in a bit. All right, so different story. Different story with a full belly, eh? Behind his heel, nothing, and he still went for it. He either doesn't care about his life or he had a fight with his wife. Wants to get in. Don't know. Look, 500 meters to the overtaking line. I never seen so many impatient drivers like in between Perth and Carnarvon on a coastal highway. right. Let's do it.